So ad hoc judges are also called temporary judges. Next, attendance of the retired Supreme Court judges as well as sitting judges of the Supreme Court. Next, court of records. Which is the court of record? That is Supreme Court. Next, original jurisdiction and seat of Supreme Court. Next, appellate jurisdiction of Supreme Court from High Court. Next, special leave petition. That is, an individual takes special permission to be heard in appeal against any High Court or tribunals or tribunal courts. That is, for example, Krishna Godavari Water, next to Narmada River Water Tribunals, etc. etc. to the Supreme Court of India. Next, review of the judgments by Supreme Court. That is, the Supreme Court has the only power to review any judgment made by it. That means Supreme Court can correct his its judgment again, which was the judgment was already given by itself. Next, enlargement of jurisdiction by Supreme Court. That is, Supreme Court has such power with respect to any matter in union list. How many subjects are in union list? There are 97. State list 66. Concurrent list 47. Next, conferment on Supreme Court of powers to issue certain writs. That is, habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibition, quo warranto, certiorari, etc. Next, transfer of certain cases. That is, all same cases can withdraw the Supreme Court from any High Court to dispose all cases itself. Next, ancillary power of the Supreme Court. Next, relation between Supreme Court and all courts in India. That is, law declared by the Supreme Court shall be binding on all courts within the territory of India. Next, making Supreme Court orders. Making the Supreme Court orders, that means, for example, cancellation of the all telecom licenses. Next, decision to the ban of the sale of diesel cars with the engine capacity of 2000 cc. Next, power of president to consult the Supreme Court in case of High Court and Supreme Court judges, and also for some legal advices from CJI means Chief Justice of India. Next, civil and judicial authorities to act in the aid of Supreme Court. That is, all civil and judicial authorities in India shall act in the aid of the Supreme Court. Next, rules of court. Next, expenses of the Supreme Court. That is, officers, servants of the Supreme Court, etc. Next, interpretation. Interpretation of some terminologies. There is a for any substantial question of law as to the interpretation of the Government of India Act. Government of India Act 1935. Next, CAG means Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Next, powers and functions of the CAG. That means Comptroller and Auditor General of India. Next, state and union accounts formation. That is, formation of accounts of states and union after consultation of the Comptroller and Auditor General. Next, audit reports. That is, that means the union accounts, state accounts, to submit the president as well as governors by the CAG. Next, National Judicial Appointments Commission. that commission contains CJI acts as a chairman. Next, two senior judges of Supreme Court. Next, Union Law Minister. Next, Prime Minister and Opposition Leader. Next, powers of Parliament to make law. Next, Part 6. Part 6 tells about the states. The articles from the articles of the states from 152 to next to 237. That means states. The definition of the states. For example, state doesn't include the Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir because it has separate flag as well as separate constitution also. Next, executive powers of the state. That is, governor is the executive head of the state. But in the center, president is the executive head of the state. Next, appointments, terms of office, qualifications, conditions, oaths and affirmations, powers, discharge of functions of the ministers to the governor. Next, other provisions of the ministers. Next, Advocate General of the State. Here, Attorney General of the State. Next, qualifications of the Advocate General of the State and also his functions. Next, conduct of the business of the state government. Next, that is rules, orders, allocation of duties, etc. Next, duties of the CM and creation of the legislative councils in the states. Next, composition of the legislative councils as well as the assemblies in the states. Duration of the legislatures. Next, qualifications of MLAs and MLCs. MLA means member of legislative assembly. MLC means member of legislative council. Next, governor's right to address both houses. Here, President's right to address both houses, either Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. Here, either in assembly or council, legislative council, legislative assembly or legislative council. Prorogue and dissolution of the sessions. That means governor can prorogue and dissolute the any session. Next, speaker and deputy speaker as well as chairman and vice chairman. Powers, votes, vacation of the state, 60 seats, and disqualification of the members, decisions,